10 presidential candidates remain on the national ballot for the upcoming May elections. Commission on Elections spokesperson James Jimenez said the list is a mix of popular and under-the-radar names. These include Vice President Lenny Robredo, former Senator Bongbong Marcos, Senators Manny Pacquiao and Panfilo Lacson, and Manila Mayor Isko Moreno. He says everyone on the list has shown clear intent to run for office.
The people who are left on the ballot cannot be considered nuisance candidates because, number one, obviously they were able to show that they have a legitimate intention to run for office. Second, legitimate intention to run for office should not be equated with popularity. And number three, legitimate intent to run for office should not be equated with premature campaigning, which is what everyone else is doing, right? And that's the reason why everyone talks about them.
Senator and Vice Presidential candidate Francis Kiko Pangilinan banking on an upset victory in the May polls. Pangilinan says one of the main challenges he and his running mate, Vice President Lenny Robredo, are facing right now are the many lies and disinformation thrown their way. But he believes there is still time to correct the politics or the public's misconceptions about them.
I have been an advocate for farmers and fisher folk welfare and rights since 2010, so mahigit sampun taon na. And VP Lenny, in all her years, whether in or out of government service, ay talagang ang mga nasa laylayan, yung pinakamahirap ang kanyang binibigyan ng oras at panahon. Yun, hindi matatawaran yun. So yun ang hamon sa atin. Paano natin sa loob ng 3.5 months malaman ng ating mga kababayan ang katotohanan? Maaring nasa kanila ang pinakamabibigat na mga politiko, pero sa atin, nasa amin, ang pinakamabibigat na ordinaryong mamamayan na kumikilos. At yan ang magiging susi natin sa tagumpay, yung ordinaryong mamamayan na kakatok sa bahay ng kanyang kapwa, kapitbahay, kamag-anak, kaibigan, at kukumbinsihin ang sila na iboto tayo.
Should they win, Pangilinan promises a better government response to the COVID-19 pandemic.
Sa DOH, ngayon lang nagbibigay ng COVID kalinga kit 2 years into COVID, di ba? Doon mo makikita, ang unang gagawin natin, talagang palitan itong mga namumuno dyan sa COVID, sa DOH at PhilHealth. Yung maliliit nating mga namumuhunan. Ang binigay sa kanila this administration, wala pang 15 billion. So talagang kung kailangan ng matagdagan ng hanap buhay at trabaho, protektahan natin yung maliliit. 100 billion for the stimulus package. 216 billion directly assistance sa mga ilalagay sa lockdown. Another 50 plus billion para sa dagdag na bakuna.
Vice President Lenny Robredo asks the Commission on Elections to allow her COVID programs to continue during the campaign period. Robredo, who is running for president in May, is leading several programs, including Bayanihan e-Consulta, which offers free online medical consultation, and a swab cab, a mobile COVID testing facility. She has written to the COMELEC asking for an exemption for the programs. The 150-day campaign period for the May polls begins on February 8th.